And welcome to another Grafana learning journey. My name is Marie, and today I'll show you how you can transform your data in a Grafana Cloud dashboard. As part of this learning journey, you'll learn common scenarios for some of the most popular transformations, apply them to your dashboard, and in the end, export these transformations outside your dashboard. To follow along in this learning journey, you need to have a Grafana Cloud account. You also need to have a data source or an integration connected and configured. Next, you need a basic familiarity with creating dashboards and panels. And finally, some familiarity with the queries that you want to transform. Once you have all the prerequisites set up, let's start your Grafana learning journey. Transformations allow data to be changed in different ways before the visualization is shown. It's available for all supported data sources and integrations in Grafana Cloud. If your data source or integration can't provide the output that you want, transformations are a great option. With transformations, you can easily join and merge data from different queries or data sources without using an external data processing tool. You can also adjust your dashboards and visualizations as requirements evolve without waiting for changes to the upstream data pipelines. Grafana has a lot of transformations, and you can apply multiple transformations to your data, so understanding when to use each transformation can be beneficial. Grafana has a lot of transformations, and I wish I could talk about all of them, but I have limited time. So in this milestone, I'm going to discuss 5 data transformations, starting from the add field from calculation transformation. The add field from calculation transformation allows you to create a new column by performing a custom calculation on one or more existing fields in your data. Use this for when you need to create a new field, such as calculating the total, difference, percentage, or ratio. The group by transformation allows you to group rows that share the same values in one or more fields. It's similar to the SQL group by clause. Use this when you need to aggregate data based on one or more fields, such as grouping by a specific category or region. The filter data by values transformation allows you to include or exclude rows based on specific values in one or more fields. It's similar to the SQL WHERE clause. Use this transformation to selectively filter data points directly within your visualization. The join by field transformation is used to combine two or more data tables that share a common field. It's similar to the SQL join clause. Use this transformation to merge multiple results into a single table, enabling the consolidation of data from different queries. Finally, the organize fields by name transformation allows you to rename, reorder, or hide fields returned by a single query in your panel. Use this to make your visualizations more organized, especially after applying multiple transformations. It's up to you if you want to learn how all these transformations work, or you can choose which transformation you want to focus on. If you are watching this from the Grafana Learning Journey documentation, you can jump to the transformation by going to the correct milestone. Or if you are watching this from our YouTube channel, you can skip to the correct chapters. I'm now going to demo how each of these data transformations work. To demo the add field from calculation transformation, I have the following visualization which shows a table containing a dummy website traffic. I want to calculate the average views per user in each of the country here and show it as a new column. To apply the add field from calculation transformation, click the Transformations tab followed by the Add Transformations button. Next, let's select the add field from the calculation transformation. Under Mode, I'm going to select the mode of operation. Since this would be a basic binary operation, I'm going to select binary. You can refer to this table as a guideline to help you decide which modes to choose. Now, I'm going to select the operation and the calculation. I'll also give a new name to this column by updating the alias field. The transformation should be applied automatically. If not, you can click refresh to verify. All what's left now is to save the dashboard. To demo the groove by transformation, I have another visualization here that shows the sales revenue for a specific region. I want to group by similar regions and get the total sales revenue for that region. To apply the group by transformation, click the Transformations tab followed by the Add Transformations button. Next, let's select the group by transformation. You can also search for it. Then, I'm going to select Group By on the drop-down of the fields that I want to group by. In this example, it will be the region field that I want to group. Next, let's apply the calculation on the field we want to calculate and select a calculation type. In this example, it will be calculating the total sales amount per each region. The transformation should be applied automatically. If not, you can click Refresh to verify. All what's left now is to save the dashboard. The next transformation that I'm going to demo is the filter data by values transformation. To demo the filter data by values transformation, I have the following visualization, which shows a pie chart about browser market share. To apply the filter data by values transformation, click Transformations tab, followed by the Add Transformations button. Next, let's select the filter data by values transformation, or you can search for it. On the filter type, select if you want an include or exclude filter. On the condition, select if you want the filter type to match all conditions or just match any. You can use the following table as a guideline for when to use the different conditions. In this example, I'm going to filter browsers that has lower than or equal to 5% market share. The transformation should be applied automatically. If not, you can click Refresh to verify. All what's left now is to save the dashboard. Moving on to the Join by Field transformation. To demo this transformation, I have another visualization which shows two different queries. I want to combine these two queries into one table and join them by its ID. To apply the Join by Field transformation, click the Transformations tab followed by the Add Transformations button. Next, find the Join by Field transformation. You can also search for it. Under Mode, select how you want your queries to be joined. You can use the following table as a guideline for when to use the different modes. In this example, I'm going to choose Inner Join. Next, select the field to be joined from the two tables. In this example, it will be the product ID. The transformation should be applied automatically. If not, you can click Refresh to verify. All what's left now is to save the dashboard. The final transformation that I'm going to demo is the Organize Fields by Name. To demo this transformation, I have another visualization that shows different car makes and models and displays the information as a table. I want to hide some of the fields and rename some of them. To apply the Organize Fields by Name transformation, click the Transformations tab followed by the Add Transformations button. Next, find or search the transformation. Choose if you want to reorder the fields manually or automatically. In this example, I'm going to keep the option as manual. To hide some of the fields, click the eye icon to disable them. In this example, I'm going to hide the year and origin fields. I'm also going to rename the miles per gallon field. The transformation should be applied automatically. If not, you can click Refresh to verify. All what's left now is to save the dashboard. In this milestone, you're going to learn how to export your data transformations outside Grafana Cloud. By default, Grafana doesn't support exporting your data transformations directly to an external database or other tools. However, you can export the data transformation manually as a CSV file. To export the transformation, click the Queries tab and then the Query Inspector button. Select the Data tab and expand the Data Options row. Enable the Apply Panel Transformation option. And finally, click the Download CSV button. You should now have a CSV file with the transformation applied to your data. Congratulations on completing this learning journey. I hope you enjoyed this video while you learn about the value of data transformations, how to apply common data transformations to your dashboard, and finally, how you can export them as a CSV file manually outside of Grafana Cloud. If you find this type of learning useful, why don't you check out the rest of our Grafana learning journeys at grafana.com/docs/learning-journeys. I hope to see you on the next one. Happy visualizing!